Hello viewers.
In this video, we are going to discuss about the subset and power set. Look at this. A, we have taken elements 1 and 3, set A, and B containing 1, 2, 3, 5, and C, X. X is an odd natural number less than 4. So, what are the value of members of C are odd natural number, that is 1, 3. So, in this case, all the elements of A contain in B. All elements of A also
elements of set B.
B. Also, you can write that all elements of A also elements of set C. So, here we are getting three sets A, B, C. In case of B, contains all the elements of A and some more elements. But C contains all the elements of A, no extra element. So, here A is said to be subset of B. A is a subset of B. A is a subset of C, but A not equal to B and A equals to C. So, every element of a subset A is contained in B, then A is called subset of B. So, here A is a subset of B and A is a subset of C. But as A not equal to B, you can say that A is a proper subset. A is a proper subset of B. So, A is a proper subset of B. And B is called superset of A. When a set is said to be superset, when the set contains all elements of the another set plus few elements which are not belongs to subset. And A and C, we can say C contains all elements of A and A contains all elements of C. So, in this case, A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A. Now, we are getting some properties. As every set is a subset of itself, because all elements of set contains in the another set, if you take that same set, that is subset of itself. An empty set is, or a null set, is a subset of every set. No elements, the set which contains no element is also a subset of every set. If a non-empty set with cardinal number m, then the number of subsets would be 2 to the power n. Let us discuss about this one. Say A is equals to 1 and 2. Then subsets of A first will write null set, then a set which contains one element, that is 1 and 2, and the set which contains both the elements 1 and 2. So, these are the subsets of A, and we see here NA is equals to 2, and if I subsets of A here, number of subsets one, two, three, four. That is 2 to the power 2. So it satisfies this relation. If a non-empty set A has m elements, then number of subsets of A will be 2 to the power n minus 1, because the set itself is not a proper subset. So, here the number of proper subsets we are getting 2 to the power m minus 1. Now, we are taking another example. A contains 1, 2 and 3. In subsets of A are null set, singleton sets 1, 2, 3, then double sets 1, 2, 1, 3, and 2, 3. Set contains 5, that is 1, 2, 3. So here it is 3 element and it's a A itself. Or this equals to set A. So here you also see NA is equals to 3. And number of subsets is equals to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which equals to 2 to the power 3. So, that also support this. The number of subsets is 2 to the power m when the number of elements in set A is n. Now, power set of a set. So, just now we have learned that what are the subsets, and power set is defined like this. The set A, A B is set, and power set of A denoted by P of A, X such that X is a subset of A. X includes in set A. That means if A, let A is equals to X and A, then subsets of A, first of all null set, singleton set, double set. So, this any one is member, that is X. So, for set we will write P of A. Which contains so all subsets of A includes in power set. So here X belongs to A. Belongs to A.
Sorry, this is A.
X and A belongs to PA. So, you can say the number of elements of PA equals to 2 to the power m when number of elements in set A is equals to m.
Here we have different sum sets.
First one is capital N, which represent x is a natural number, and natural numbers are 1, 2, 3. Next one is W. W means it is x such that x is a whole number. So, all whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3 is represented by W. And clearly, W is N includes in W. And then another set I or Z is set of all integers. That means 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2,
and continue.
Clearly,
all whole numbers are integers.
Next, we defined set of irrational numbers. So, number is 0, then all numbers less than 1, one and a half, two, etc. And that is minus 1, minus half, etc. So this is a finite set, and all integers are also contained in set of rational numbers. So all integers are rational numbers, but all rational numbers are not integers. Next, set of real number x. So here root 2, root 3 are also belong to this. R plus, it's a positive real number.
QC, numbers which are real number but not rational.
Root 2, root 2 by 5, root 3. So these are all examples, non-terminating, non-negative numbers, 0.5, 1. So they are also, so irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are not rational numbers. So irrational numbers also contained in R. In fact, rational number and irrational number, their union is equals to R. So, N is its proper subset of whole number. Whole number is a proper subset of integer. Integer is a proper subset of rational number, and rational number is a proper subset of real number. Okay. Thank you.
For testing your understanding of this lesson and more videos, log on to www.tubelessons.net.